Good job. Ong, kunu jom reh, kah buto, kah jom naka, nitik biti sam naka. Jom naka, sam naka, nơi prak ni, ong, kunu jom reh, nâng buto, su jom lai, kunu jop chao nun chia, doi, nơi likhat chun nâng dol phi ki, ka pi, thangai, ti mok phai pung pul. Menteri Jelaka meribroy pedap pedap sembelinya bakuat ter ayam dek di ay ner khat leu makang khat leu khang cuci rib kat dia. เรื่องปรกนี้องจำเรียกมันโตก็จำนาคาน้องกาสู่จุดจับเจ้าหนุนจีโดยสหปริญญาให้องจำเรียกส่งลึกสหปริญญาท่าสหปริญญาเมียนไปเรียแต่ไม่ปรกเตียดไม่ปรกนิตย์แต่บนนอกดิฉันได้ส่งสหปริญญากัดกู้ของปีไปเรียนนี่ถือว่าน่าเอา
Thank you, Mr. President.
Tamnang Sapinya and Rachir Somakun Lokthien.
Mr. Nun Chia, when we were last questioning you, we were talking about the subject of cities and towns in Cambodia and what happened there when they were liberated in the 1972 to 1974 time period. So I'd like to return now to a few general questions about the party's policy. Do you recall whether in that time period, 1972 to 73, whether there were any disagreements between the party leaders as to whether or not to abolish private property?
สมกรุบโลกประเทศสมกรุบบองโอนรวมเจียดออกตีนี้ตูเสียงประเทศตามเข้มจำ
Were there any party leaders in the 1972 or 1973 time period who were not in favor of abolishing private property?
តាមខ្ញុំចាំមិនមានលុបចោលកម្មសិទ្ធិឯកជនទេមានតែបញ្ហាដីឯទ្រព្យសម្បត្តិរួមឯទ្រព្យសម្បត្តិឯទុកជាឯកជនទាំងអស់ដីធ្លីយកមកជួយសហគមន៍សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធាន
Well, let me read to you a statement from the February to March 1976 Revolutionary Flag. It contains the following statement, quote, in mid-1972, the party announced an emergency regarding petty bourgeoisie class stances and capitalism class stances inside the party. This was the opening stage of the struggle within the party by going on a profound offensive, continuing later. The party did not just fight within the party also fought in the society by opening a stage of education to prepare the preconditions to establish the cooperatives. This is from document So my question to you, Mr. Nunche, is simply whether you recall in the 1972 period there being an emergency because the party leadership viewed that there were people within the party who maintained capitalist and petty bourgeoisie class stances. Do you recall that?
ខ្ញុំសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានបញ្ហានេះជាខាងផ្នែករដ្ឋាភិបាលហើយខាងខ្ញុំខាងបកទទួលខាងអប់រំនឹងទៅដូច្នោះខ្ញុំមិនទាក់ទងអីនឹងបញ្ហាខាងរដ្ឋបាលទេ
Is it correct Mr. Nunchea, that in mid-1973, the party decided to begin implementing cooperatives in the liberated territories?
ពីសមាគមស្រូវសមាគមជួយឧបត្ថម្ភគ្នាពេលឈឺថ្កាត់សមាគមជួយសង្គ្រោះគ្នាអីអីសិនបន្តិចបន្តិចទៅពីទៀបទៅខ្ពស់ហើយបានក្រោយមកទៀតបានពេលណាសមាគមនេះបានពង្រីកទៅទើបចាប់ផ្ដើមចាត់តាំងសហគមន៍បណ្ដាលហៅថាសហគមន៍ថ្នាក់ទៀប
There are numerous party documents, Mr. Nunche, that refer to the 20th of May, 1973, as the birth date on which the party started to implement cooperatives. Do you recall, is there some significance to the date of 20 May, 1973?
Som chumriep ruk prathean khnyom mun cham te.
When is it that you recall that cooperatives were first established?
Tam da luk cham sahko ban bongkaet chi leuk dambong nei chnam na dae.
Som chumriep ruk prathean sahko mun men chat tang tu chang prateh phliem te. Kue kanlai na dae angka maha chuan đối với nhóm ban chấm riệp mình nâng cứ đối với sầm ma cung sầu sầm ma cung chui song cuộc nia rừng hơi ban chập cái này nâng chặt tăng sa hạ có đa đa đối với nó vừa mình ban prom nia tê rồi tôi cũng nói nam nó vừa mình ban đi bị pro bậc khóc nia sập hiệp ca khóc nia ai chặt tăng đấy chặt tăng bị kháng chống cát mệt nhau một mùn mình bên chặt tăng ti bị chùm chuôn môn đi
What was the party's reason for forming and organizing cooperatives?
Sống rạch ở miền ca chặt tăng bằng ca chia sạ co nu.
Sống chùm riêng lúc bật thiền. Bạn sống rạch chặt tăng sạ co nhằm sống chùm riêng sạ. ជាខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់សហគមន៍ទៀតសិនមូលហេតុគឺមកដើម្បីប្រមូលប្រជាជនបើធ្វើការរឹតរាយទៅវាខាតកម្លាំងពលកម្មឧទាហរណ៍អបមាថា 50 គ្រួសារ 50 គ្រួសារនេះបើដាំបាយវាត្រូវខាត 50នាក់ 60នាក់ដែរ bên bài chặt tăng sa hạ có rùm khnia thua ca nghe rùm khnia hộp bài tấu chậm nai một nút tết hơi chậm nén ở thua bột là cam trơn
Who was it that made the decision to implement cooperatives? Was that a decision of the standing committee or the central committee?
ជាការសម្ដែងពីគណៈមជ្ឈមឬគណៈអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍ឬក៏យ៉ាងម៉េចសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានបញ្ហានេះគឺគណៈអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍ជាអ្នកសម្ដែងក៏ប៉ុន្តែបញ្ហានេះស្ដាប់មតិពីខាងក្រោមពីកសិករក្រកសិករកណ្ដាលឡើងមកគឺបានស្ដីថាស្ដាប់មតិមហាជនសិនបានរៀបចំចាត់តាំងបើមហាជនគេសុខចិត្តហើយ Some young chat tang sa ha call.
I'd like to read to you from a party circular that is entitled Third Year Anniversary of the Organization of Peasant Cooperatives, 20th May 1973 to 20th May 1976. This is document D. 366/7.1.61, which is before the trial chamber as E3/50. That document contains the following statement. Quote, in 1972-73, the party took measures to organize the people based on political consciousness in view of thwarting the economic power of landowners and capitalists, cut off private trading, control traders, dismantle the former means of production, establish new ones, and organize cooperatives. Period. Chief among the measures was the organization of cooperatives, period. It consisted of attacking the power of the classes of the feudalists, landowners, and capitalists, end of quote. This is from English ERN 00636009, French ERN 00623783, and Khmer ERN 00442 2049. My question to you, Mr. Nunchea, is whether the implementation of cooperatives was part of the party's political attack against landowners and feudalists.
របស់ប៉ដើម្បីធ្វើយ៉ាងណាវាប្រហែលទៅលើអ្នកដែលជាម្ចាស់ដីឬក៏នីទុនមិនមែនដែរទេពួកសក្តិភូមិមិនមែនដែរទេសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានការចាត់តាំងសហគរខ្ញុំនៅខាងប៉ទទួលនីតិខាងអប់រំឯសហគរនៅខាងរដ្ឋបាលក៏ប៉ុន្តែតាមខ្ញុំដឹងខ្លះ
Mr. Nunchea, did you not educate party cadres in various regions as to how to organize cooperatives?
កម្មាភិបាលនៅក្នុងតាមតំបន់មួយចំនួនអំពីរបៀបនៃការបង្កើតសហគមន៍ទេឬក៏យ៉ាងណានោះសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានការចាត់តាំងសហគមន៍ខ្ញុំមិនបានអប់រំទេអប់រំតែការចាត់តាំងសមាគមស្រូវសមាគមអីអីអស់នេះផ្សេងផ្សេងទេឯសហគមន៍ខាងផ្នែករដ្ឋាភិបាលគេចាត់តាំងគេរៀបចំ
When you say the government, who are you referring to?
សំណួរនៅពេលដែលលោកនិយាយថារដ្ឋាភិបាលរដ្ឋាភិបាលជាអ្នកចាត់តាំងនៅតើលោកសំដៅលើនៅណាគេដែរគឺចាត់តាំងគឺរដ្ឋាភិបាលកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យគឺកាត់កាលនោះដូចមិនចាត់លោកសួរឆ្នាំ 72 73កាលនោះដូចមិនតាន់បានរំដោះផងចិត្ត 2 ចិត្ត 3 នេះនៅក្នុងរដ្ឋាភិបាលសង្គម
Yes, Mr. Nunchea, but at that time a substantial part of the country was under the control of the Khmer Rouge. In the areas that you controlled in 1973, did you not begin to implement cooperatives at that time?
តាមខ្ញុំតាំងខាងផ្នែកគណៈតំបន់គីអប់រំបណ្ដាលដូចខ្ញុំជម្រាបអញ្ចឹង មិនមែនដាក់ភ្លៀងពីព្រោះការភ្ញាក់រលឹករបស់ប្រជាជនជាពិសេសប្រជាជននៅចុងកាត់មាត់ញោកមិនទាន់យល់ច្បាស់ហើយក៏មិនទាន់យល់ពីការចាត់តាំងសហគមន៍អីទេយល់តែពីចាត់តាំងអង្គការផ្សេងផ្សេងអង្គការសមាគមស្រូវអីដូចខ្ញុំជម្រាបអញ្ចឹងហើយជួយខ្ញុំធ្វើបណ្ដើរទៅ
All right, let me move to another area, Mr.
Nunchea.
Could you tell the chamber what Son Sen's role was during the period from 1973 to April 1975? Did he have any role in relation to the military?
ជំរាបលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេក៏ប៉ុន្តែគាត់នៅក្នុងគណៈអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍ដែរ
How often were you present in Phnom Penh between 1972 and the 17th of April
1975?
When was the last time that you were in Phnom Penh prior to the capture and liberation of the city by CPK forces on the 17th of April 1975? When was the last time before that you were in Phnom Penh? My question to you, Mr. Nun Che, was when was the last time you were in Phnom Penh prior to the 17th of April 1975? Okay, you've just told us that you were at the Stung Chinit River on the 17th of April 1975. My question is, when was the last time you were in Phnom Penh before then? Let me try it another way, Mr. Nun Che. Did you spend any time in Phnom Penh in January 1975, February 1975, or March 1975, the months leading up to the capture of Phnom Penh by the Khmer Rouge on the 17th of April?
Chúng là hãy xâm ở xu ở khlấy đi quật miền bà xa mình chẳng hãy bỏ prai ở chú bác hãy cầm nhộp. Thì nhộp quật sẽ đạo bán cho lộp cho lòng hôm nay. Nhưng sẽ đạp khơi quật quật cho lộp cho lòng bị bị đoàn hả? Xâm ở quân.
Ở quân cả quật không có là bỏ lộp. mình chỉ vì cả việc cái đấy sẽ chỉ thêm đoàn thiết bằng những đề xong lực đó là xã nhà trại chiết xong xã phụ nhà điệp trong xong nua khlây khlây đâm bây ơi quật nghề dùl vì bà thân cho miền cao bình dùl về tới hai bàn tăng xong nua nực nông nút à cho miền bánh hà đây để xa chỉ lòng rồi miền cao bình dùl hay nâng tăng xong nua hay nè bộ prae được kia xong miền cao bộ prae bàn dứt hay nâng chạy chấp bạc đâm bây sẽ đạp dùl xong chơi tăng xong nua mấy mấy ní thay chứ thamay mà đồng tiết
My question is very simple, Mr. Nunchia. Were you present at any time in Phnom Penh in January, February, or March
1975? ឆ្នាំ 1975 ដើមខែឧសភាកងទ័ពវៀតណាមឈ្លានពានចូលបរិវេណខាងឆ្នេរសមុទ្រខាងខេត្តកំពតយុគទី 8កងថ្ងៃទី 8ឧសភាកងទ័ពវៀតណាមចូលដីខ្មែរនៅចប់ព្រំដែនខេត្តតៃនិញ ទៅពេលនោះណា ពេលកងទ័ពវៀតណាមចូលហើយពួកខាងខ្ញុំក៏ជំនឿទៅនៅជនបទព្រំដែនថៃសូមសួរម្ដងទៀតឲ្យលោកតំណាងសហប្រជាជាតិ អាចតាំងសំណួរជាក់ច្បាស់ជាងនេះបានទេគាត់ដូចជាស្ដាប់សំណួរមិនបានទេឆ្លើយនៅការបរិឆេទផ្សេងក្រៅពីផុតពីសំណួរដែលលោកសួរលោកសួរគឺក្នុងអំឡុងខែ 1 ហើយដល់ខែមេសាឆ្នាំចិត្តប្រាំចំណែកឯគាត់គាត់ឆ្លើយខែឧសភាឆ្នាំចិត្តប្រាំទៅហើយ
Thank you, Mr. President. I'll try one more time.
My question was not in relation to the period after 1975.
Now, in your testimony on the 14th of December 2011, you stated that during the period Mr. Ieng Sary was in Beijing, he came back to Cambodia every 5 or 6 months. My question to you is, can you tell the chamber how many times Mr. Ieng Sary returned to Cambodia in 1973 and 1974? Do you recall how many times he came back to Cambodia during that time period?
ហើយត្រឡប់មកវិញយើងដឹងមកពីរដងទៅពីរដងមិនដឹងទេ
What were the two occasions that you remember Ing Sirie returning to Cambodia in 1973
or 1974?
I am correct then that in relation to the second or the other time that Ing Sirie returned, you don't recall the time period. คือถ้าปลปลปอดก็ปรับខ្ញុំថាការងារខាងនោះទុកឲ្យគេធ្វើទៅខាងពួកបញ្ញាជនខាងអីអីនោះអែមិតអនុវត្តមេគារណាសេជាមួយបញ្ញាជនវាមិនភោផងដូច្នោះគិតតែខាងអប់រំទៅ
Okay, now I'd like to ask you a few more questions about some of the towns, the cities that were liberated by CBK forces prior to the 17th of April, 1975. When we broke last time, a passage from a revolutionary flag was read to you that described the practice of seizing the people. And one of the examples that was given was in relation to Banham Town. And let me just read to you again the statement from the December 1976 to January 1977 revolutionary flag, which said the following regarding the liberation of Banham in 1973. Quote, we took everyone in Banham Town, expelling the ethnic Vietnamese, the ethnic Chinese, the military, the police. We took everyone, drawing up the people from the enemy. End of quote. And this is document D243/2.1.9 at Khmer URN 00630640, English 00491424
and French
00504949. Can you tell us, first of all, where was
What about Udong?
The same
issue of revolutionary flag contained the following statement about Udong. Quote, we liberated Udong in 1974 and pulled out all the people. Do you, can you tell the chamber whose military forces were involved in the capture of Udong in 1974?
ខ្ញុំមិនមានភារកិច្ចអីខាងកងតបទេ khang kong top kuk khang pol pot khang sun sein te
Do you know what was done with the residents of Udong after the city was captured by the party's military forces in 1974?
នៅតាមជនបទពីព្រោះពេលនោះខ្វះស្បៀងហើយភ្នំពេញខ្វះស្បៀងតាំងពីឆ្នាំ1973ដូច្នោះប្រជាជនគ្មានអីហូបទេដូច្នោះត្រូវរួមគ្នាបង្កបង្កើនផលនៅជនបទទៅធ្វើសហគមន៍នៅនោះនេះតាមខ្ញុំចាំទេខ្ញុំមិនបានទៅធ្វើផ្ទាល់ទេ
Well, in a speech he gave in North Korea in early April 1974, Kyusam Phan described the attack on Udong as follows. Quote, on 18 March, our people's National Liberation Armed Forces liberated another city, Udong, by annihilating all the puppet soldiers there along with the reinforcements. In other words, over 5,000 enemies were eliminated, 1,500 of whom were captured and quote. This is document IS-12.7 at English ERN 00280586, French ERN S-0000122, and Khmer ERN 00596141. Mr. Nunchia, are you able to tell the chamber what was done with the 1,500 enemies who were captured in Udong? Well, Udong was near the party base in Kampong Tralak district, Pim Commune that we've discussed before. Did the party have military bases and security offices in that region in
1974?
Mr. Nunchea, the September to October 1976 revolutionary flag, which is document D243/63095031, French ERN 00491897. That issue of revolutionary flag contains the following statement, quote, when we evacuated the people from the cities, we carried out class struggle, end of quote. Can you explain to the chamber how you were carrying out class struggle by evacuating people from cities?
ប្រឆាំងនឹងប្រជាជនដែលជំនះឬក៏តាមរយៈការជំនះប្រជាជនចេញពីទីក្រុងនឹងជាការតស៊ូបែបណាសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេពីរឿងការតស៊ូវណ្ណៈក៏ប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំចាំអញ្ចេះគឺថារួមគ្នាធ្វើសហការទៅដើម្បីចែកគ្នាហូប ឯតស៊ូវណ្ណៈទៅរឹបយកអីអីអីបើគេនោះខ្ញុំមិនដឹងទេ ព្រោះដូចខ្ញុំជម្រាបអដែលព្រោះខ្ញុំនៅខាងអប់រំឯខាងអប់រំហ្នឹងគឺថាវាមានគោលការណ៍របស់វាគឺថាមួយកំប៉ះពលទ្រព្យសម្បត្តិប្រជាជនកំប្រើអាណាអំណាចកំប្រើអាញាកំស្រីកំស្រាកំលួយកំកាក់កំលបែងស៊ីសងហើយឥតយ៉ាងម៉េចខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេព្រោះវាច្រើនឆ្នាំមកដល់ហើយ
Thank you, Mr. Nunchea. I'd now like to turn to questions regarding the decision of the party to evacuate Phnom Penh. You stated in your testimony on the 13th of December 2011 that the decision to evacuate Phnom Penh was made in a, quote, series of meetings. You've so far described one of those meetings in mid-1974 extraordinary meeting of the Central Committee. Can you identify for the chamber the other meetings in that series of meetings which decided on the evacuation of Phnom Penh?
ដែលសម្រាប់ខ្ញុំជំរាបលោកប្រធានការប្រជុំនឹង ខ្ញុំចាំប្រជុំឆ្នាំ1960ម្ដងអានឹងមិនតើមានចម្រៀសទេការប្រជុំឆ្នាំ1961ម្ដងប្រជុំឆ្នាំ1961ម្ដងប្រហែលមក1973ម្ដង
Okay, Mr. Nunchea, I'm asking about specifically about the decision to evacuate Phnom Penh, and you previously described in detail a mid-1974 extraordinary meeting of the Central Committee where that decision was made. Do you recall that meeting, Mr. Nunchea? Yes or no? Yes, 1974. Was there an extraordinary meeting of the Central Committee in mid-1974 that made the decision to evacuate Phnom Penh?
តាមខ្ញុំចាំដូចមានវិព្រោះពេលនោះសភាសហរដ្ឋដូចជាកាត់ថាវិការមិនអោយកប៉ាល់រហោះអាមេរិកទម្លាក់គ្របបែកលើប្រទេសកម្ពុជាទេដូច្នោះកងទ័ពលន់ដល់កាន់តែអន់ហើយស្បៀងអាហារក៏គ្មាន
And trying to pinpoint exactly when that meeting took place. There is a statement in the September 1977 Revolutionary Flag that reads as follows, quote, "It was during this situation when our party's central committee, in the course of its June 1974 conference, resolved to mount a decisive offensive to liberate Phnom Penh and the entire country. And that is from document D43/2.1.12 at Khmer ERM 0063 16 2 English 0 0 4 7 2 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 3 4 7 8 to evacuate Phnom Penh? Was that a meeting that took place in June 1974?
ដែលធ្វើឡើងនៅខែមិថុនាឆ្នាំ1974ដែរឬទេ?
សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានដោយខ្ញុំជម្រាបវិញហើយ
Do you recall where it was that the meeting of the Central Committee that decided to evacuate Phnom Penh? Do you recall where that meeting was held?
Well,
I was told that
How long did the meeting last?
សាភិញ្ញាតាលោកចាំទេប្រជុំនឹងរយៈពេលប្រមាណដែរប្រមាណម៉ោងឬប្រមាណថ្ងៃដែរបាទ
ប្រជុំនឹងតាមខ្ញុំចាំប្រហែល3ថ្ងៃក្នុងគរុបរូបធាន
And how many people សាភិញ្ញា
ថាតើសមាជិកអង្គប្រជុំពេលនោះមានគ្នាប្រមាណអ្នក
ខ្ញុំជម្រាបលោកប្រធានមិនខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេប៉ុន្តែមានតំណាងភៀកដែលជាគណៈមជ្ឈិមដែលទៅចុះសកម្មភៀកនោះមកគ្រប់ភៀកមកប្រជុំ
Can you identify for the chamber the people, the names of the people who attended that meeting other than yourself?
But Chumoo Samachik Ong Pachum Nung, Krau Pi Lok Nung Mien Nek Na Tiet, but Oy Tulaka Ban Chirip Pong.
Tam Khem Cham, Pol Pot, Nyom, Nguyen Chia, Tamok,សូភុំកុយធួនទៅតាមខ្ញុំចាំបានប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Would you agree that you cannot remember all of the people who attended that meeting, Mr. Nguyen Chia?
ឈ្មោះមនុស្សទាំងអស់ដែលចូលរួមកិច្ចប្រ
ជុំហ្នឹងទេតើអញ្ចឹងមែនទេលោកមែនអូសុនសេនអត់ទោ
Sa Pinya, the Lok Cham Te, Nong Chanam Pomoroy Chet Sapun, a delegation from China coming to Cambodia to to do a film about the liberated zone? Do you have any recollection of that?
ខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេ
Thank you. You have described to the chamber how food shortages in Phnom Penh were a major reason for the 1974 decision of the Central Committee to evacuate Phnom Penh.
Well, when the Central Committee made its decision to evacuate Phnom Penh, Mr. Nguyen Chea, did it allow any people to stay in Phnom Penh, or was the decision that all residents of Phnom Penh
were to be evacuated? I was the decision that all residents of
I understand that there was a committee established. When the Central Committee, though, made its decision in mid-1974, was the decision to evacuate all residents of Phnom Penh?
Yes, that was the decision to evacuate all residents of Phnom Penh.
ปันตปันดาอสันเด้จำการนับเราไปปินิดมือสเพียบกาปีปลวกการนั้นเราเมียนตำเนาะบ่เขียมในเยเจ้าเวงเต้ไปรำดอกพนมปิ้งเนี่ยกองตอบเวียดนามรำดอกกราวอีเต้ก็ปันตายกองตอบเวียดนาม บ้านโจลสุขนำพรุ่งพรุ่งปิงเฮ้ยไอ้กราบีนี้ก็เมียนกระเป๋าจำบังหรือว่าอเมริกช่วยอาไมเกตบางจอดนู่นนี่ก็ต่างโดยฉะนั้นคณะประชุมยุลคืนทาบากานา การสังเคราะห์ในกรุงตีกรุงพนมเปญ ប្រជាជនស្លាប់ច្រើនហើយប្រជាជនស្លាប់ច្រើនណាស់ហើយក៏គ្មានស្អីហូបទៀតដូច្នោះយើងសោកចិត្តឲ្យលំបាកសិនចុះហើយយើងទៅនោះក៏ខំឲ្យសហគមន៍ខំពង្រឹងសហគមន៍ឡើងដើម្បីជួយដោះស្រាយស្បៀងឲ្យប្រជាជនដែលជំលាអានឹងគឺមានទស្សនៈយ៉ាងនេះ ไว้บ่ประสนาจะอเมริกาบังการสงครามទៀតពេលរំដោះតើវៀតណាមខាងជើងវៀតណាមខាងត្បូងតើវៀតណាមវៀតកុងកាលនោះហៅវៀតកុងតើចូលជ្រៀតជ្រែកយ៉ាងម៉េចបញ្ហានេះវាស្មុគស្មាញណាស់លោកប្រធានមានទាំងអាមេរិកមានទាំងយួនធាវគី
Well, because the Central Committee decided that all residents were to be evacuated, that meant that sick people and patients in hospitals
អ្នកជំងឺត្រូវតែជំនះត្រូវតែអង្គការជំនះឲ្យអស់ពីភ្នំពេញទេត្រូវទេជំនះទាំងអស់ជួយផ្សែងជួយអីគ្នាទៅអ្នកណាគេមានឡានក៏គេទៅឡានទៅអ្នកណាមានអតេះអូសក៏ទៅអតេះអូសទៅព្រោះធ្វើម៉េចឲ្យចេញវិផុតពីទីក្រុងស្រី
How many hospitals were there in Phnom Penh in 1974?
ខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេប៉ុន្តែចាំសំខាន់វាពេទ្យសនេមិត្តភាពសូវៀតហើយពេទ្យរាជការ
When the Central Committee made its decision to evacuate all residents of Phnom Penh, did you make any effort to determine how many hospitals there were in Phnom Penh and how many patients were in those
hospitals?
มันได้บ้านเกิดเตะจำส้มจำเรียบรูปเทียนอะไรจะเกิดไอ้หน้าบนสภาพกาวดอลเลยสำคัญนะใครเพราะเป็นนู่นใจไประบายพรุ่งปีเนี่ยสงกทันเนี่ยสงกทันเนี่ยตอนนู้นเวียดนามตะโบงก็ปีขายมุนตัวรีบจอมตอบหน่อยเนาะ ហើយពេលបែកកងតបចន្ទរង្សីនាំកងតបមួយចំនួនប្រមាណប្រហែលប្រមាណកងវរៈសនាធំទៅថៃដូច្នោះគណៈមជ្ឈិមហើយនៅក្នុងទីក្រុងភ្នំពេញតាមផ្ទះមួយមួយសត្វដាក់បារ៉ែតដូច្នោះគណៈមជ្ឈិមគណៈអចិន្ត្រៃយ៍យល់ឃើញថាអាមេរិកមកលើសកលលោក ដូចមិនដែលឲ្យឯណាណាមិនដែលធ្វើបត្តវត្តណាវាយយកបានទីក្រុងទេដូច្នោះខ្លាចជាវាយកលរបស់គេអានឹងឲ្យត្រូវប្រយ័ត្នហើយពិសេសទៅពេលអាមេរិកវាយតើវៀតណាមវៀតកុងនៅស្ងៀមទេព្រោះវៀតកុងចាំតែមើល វិកកងស្ដាយណាស់ស្ដាយភ្នំពេញរំដោះមុនហាណូយមុនវៀតណាមខាងត្បូងក៏ស្ដាយណាស់ក៏ថាទោះបីជារំដោះណែភាគខាងត្បូងបានប៉ុន្តែបើយើងក្តាប់បើយើងយកភ្នំពេញមិនបាននេះ មតិរបស់អ្នកដឹកនាំវៀតណាម
Mr. Nunchea, were there any members of the Standing or Central Committee who disagreed with the decision to evacuate Phnom Penh? After the mid-1974 meeting of the Central Committee, where the decision was made to evacuate Phnom Penh, did you participate in any more meetings regarding the evacuation of Phnom Penh, or was that the last meeting that you participated in on that subject?
At
the same mid-1974 meeting of the Central Committee that you've described, did the Central Committee at that same meeting also discuss enemy infiltration of the party and make a decision not to allow any new members to join the party?
ពេលនោះខ្មាំងច្រើនណាខ្ញុំសូមលើកឧទាហរណ៍មុននឹងដោះពេលដែលក្រុមដោះខាងកញ្ចេះមានកងតបគេហៅថាមួយចំនួនទៅចាត់តាំងកងតបនៅកំពង់ធំនោះមេបញ្ជាការឈ្មោះឃុតឧត្តមវង្សវឌ្ឍនា ដើម្បីរៀបចំໄວ້ខាងនោះទៀតប៉ុន្តែត្រូវប្រជាជនប្រឆាំងហើយខាងសង្ឃថាញ់រៀបចំកងទ័ពពីវៀតណាមខាងត្បូងដើម្បីតម្រង់មកໄວ້ទៀតនេះរឿងវិញចឹងហើយក្នុងភ្នំពេញ បើថាមិនជំនឿអស់ពួកដាណូសលដែលតាមសេចក្តីបំពេលនាវរបស់បកូណាឲ្យចូលព្រីម៉ាគីវាមានទាំងអ្នកល្អវាមានទាំងអ្នកអាក្រក់ចូលព្រីម៉ាគីមានពួកអ៊ីសរាចាស់ដែលខ្ញុំជំរាបសឹងឲ្យវិញទីចុះពួកពុតឆាយពួកចន្ទរង្សិពួកពុតឆាយពួកណែកោតៈ ពួកហ៊ុនវងអនុភាពពួកអីអីទុំធប់ណាដូច្នោះវាមិនមានសុភាពការស្ងប់ស្ងាត់ទេហើយពួកណែម៉ាស៊ីនទុំពួកអីអីអានេះច្រើនបាក់ច្រើនពួកណាសត្វពួកនេះសត្វពួកមិនមែន
យកឈ្មោះបដិវត្តបាំងមុខប៉ុន្តែដើររៀងគីដើររីងគីលុយប្រជាជនបើនាមឲ្យសន្លប់ស្ពេលនោះបើលោកព្រះអញ្ញានៅភ្នំពេញផងបានយល់សភាពការច្បាស់
Because of the concerns regarding enemies, is it correct that the Central Committee decided both to close the doors to any new members in the party and also to conduct internal purges in 1974? Is that correct, Mr. Nunjia?
តាមមែនដែរឬទេនៅក្នុងពាក់កណ្ដាលឆ្នាំ74នោះលោកនុនជា
ពាក់កណ្ដាល74តាមខ្ញុំចាំមិនមែនបិទទ្វារទេគឺជ្រើសរើសណាអ្នកដែលចូលបាក់ហើយមិនពេលនោះតាមខ្ញុំចាំគឺពួកដែលឆ្លៀតឱកាសនិយមពួតធ្វើបាតុកម្មហៅថាធ្វើបាតុវត្តឱកាសនិយមជ្រៀតចូលច្រើនណាស់ជាពិសេសពេលដែលបកូណាលោកពេលចូលព្រីម៉ាគីហ្នឹងដូច្នោះសភាពការវាស្មុគវាស្មាញហើយកប៉ាល់របស់អាមេរិកទម្លាក់ក្របបែក200ថ្ងៃ200យប់ពជាជនស្លាប់ច្រើនសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Let me read to you, Mr. Nunjia, from the February to March 1976 issue of Revolutionary Flag, which is document D243/2.1.3 at Khmer ERN 00063229, English ERN 00517844-517845 and French ERN 00492790. That issue contains the following statement, quote, "In early 1974, there were many problems with the enemy conducting pacifist agent activities which damaged a number of our troops, our state authorities, our male and female combatants, and our cooperative committees. Since the proletarian stance of the party was not yet solid, the enemy was able to bore holes from within our ranks." Continuing on the same page, quote, "The party assessed the situation and decided to close the door to the party and the core organizations. Along with this, there were internal purges." Do you recall, Mr. Nunjia, that in 1974, one of the groups of party cadres who were purged were the party leaders from Kokang province?
ប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំភ្លេចច្រើនដែលស្មុគស្មាញជាងគេណាគឺនៅភូមិភាគបុព្វាទេមិនមែននៅកោះកុងទេនៅភូមិភាគបុព្វាពីព្រោះកាលនោះមានឈ្មោះច័ន្ទចក្រីដែលជាមេនាំបះបោហើយវៀតណាមក៏នៅពេះពេញភូមិភាគបុព្វាហ្នឹងដើមបីខ្ញុំតាមខ្ញុំចាំចំនួនប្រហែលជា 25,000 នាក់តាមឮទេនៅសង្គ្រប់ទីកន្លែងហើយស្បៀងអាហារអីអានេះក៏អាស្រ័យនៅលើប្រទេសមករស់នៅផងមកតាំងតបផងហើយមកហូបស្បៀងអាហារបាយទឹកអីនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាទាំងអស់ដូច្នោះប្រទេសកម្ពុជាអ្នកខ្លះថាវៀតណាមមានសគុណ
នៅប្រទេសកម្ពុជាប៉ុន្តែការពិតកម្ពុជាទេដែលមានសគុណឬវៀតណាមឲ្យវៀតណាមមកជ្រកវៀតណាមមកជ្រកកោននៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាពីព្រោះពេលនោះអាមេរិកសញ្ញាក្របបៃខ្លាំងណាស់រកកន្លែងនៅគ្មានទេខ្ញុំបានសួរខ្ញុំបានសួរអ្នកស្រីងៀនធីដិញ ដែលជាប្រធានកងតបអនាសេមកជួបនៅសូភឹមដល់ត្រឡប់ទៅវិញខ្ញុំសួរថាកើតមកធ្វើអីថាកើតមកសុំកន្លែងដើម្បីឲ្យកងតបនៅពីព្រោះនៅនោះរកកន្លែងនៅគ្មានទេចង្ការកៅស៊ូវាអីនោះវាអស់ស្លឹកអស់អីទៅហើយដូច្នោះនឹងគឺថា ការពេតនឹងដូចជាប្រេងខ្ញុំជម្រាបឲ្យអស់ចុះដូចជាប្រេងដូចជាអីអីនេះបន្តកាត់តាមរតនគិរីមណ្ឌលគិរីនៅបន្តមកពីហាណូយមកតាមផ្លូវហូជីមិញណាដែលប្រេងចិនជួយអីណាដូច្នោះបច្ចុប្បន្នវៀតណាមពុតបច្ចុប្បន្នកម្ពុជានេះ ការតស៊ូរបស់កម្ពុជានេះជួយវៀតណាមមិនតិចទេព្រោះអ្នកដឹកនាំវៀតណាមកាលនោះតាំងពីឆ្នាំ 60 ដែរមកនៅក្នុងកម្ពុជាទេខ្ញុំស្គាល់ហើយដូចជាលេយុននេះងៀនវ៉ាន់ដិញនេះហៃសូនេះស្អីអីអស់នេះមករស់នៅ ແລະខាងត្បូងសាលារៀនយុទ្ធកន្ធោនៅនៅម្ដងនឹងតើមានទៅនៅវៀតណាមឯណាប៉ុន្តែអ្នកដែលមិនដឹងចេះថាវៀតណាមមានសគុណឬខ្មែរច្រើនណានេះអ្នកដែលមិនដឹងអានេះខ្ញុំសូមជម្រាបឲ្យអស់ចូលក្រៅបញ្ហាបន្តិចសូមលោកប្រធានអធិស្ឋាន ប៉ុន្តែអោយយល់ទាំងអស់គ្នាអោយបងប្អូនចំនួនក្រោយនេះយល់ធៀបពេចរបស់យល់បរិហិតតារបស់វៀតណាមយ៉ាងម៉េចអីយ៉ាងម៉េចបានប៉ុណ្្នឹងហើយដើរឃោសនាទាំងលើសកលលោកទៀតថាខ្មែរបានអាស្រ័យវៀតណាមនេះជួយទៅទៅអញ្ចឹងទៅវិញទៅ
Mr. Nunchea, do you remember a leader from the Kokong region named Prasit Elias Chong?
Lom Prasit mok me dak nuam pi khat bat akok kong no ta lok cham de.
Khnyom kran te lư de. Ni tham mok pi men men Prasit te Prasit.
And can you please tell the chamber what happened to him in 1974?
តាមខ្ញុំដឹងថាមកតាមផ្លូវមានពួកចៅព្រៃស្ទាក់វៃកាលនោះខាងកើតនៅខាងនិរដីទេកើតឡើងជាមួយចមុកហើយចមុកហៅមក
All right, Mr. Nunchea. In your opening statement, you mentioned a base or office called B5. That was located near Phim Khong. Can you tell the chamber what B5 was?
ខ្ញុំក៏ចាំមិនច្បាស់ដែរបងប៉ុន្តែបងប្រាំនេះជាកន្លែងធ្វើការមួយរបស់ប៉ុលពត
What When was that office established?
សំណួរតើបងប5នេះបង្កើតឡើងនៅក្នុងឆ្នាំណាដែរ
តាមខ្ញុំចាំពេលវាយពេលត្រៀមវាយរំដោះភ្នំពេញពលពតទៅប្រចាំការនៅគុំនៅនោះ
Who other than Pol Pot was located at the B5 office?
ក្រៅពីប៉ុលពតមាននរណាគេទៀតដែលនៅមន្ទីរប5នោះ
តាមខ្ញុំចាំគ្មានពីណាទេមានតែពួកដែលនៅភូមិភាគគេមករាយការណ៍ជូនកើតហើយមានអ្នកការពារប្រមាណអ្នកនេះព្រោះត្រូវនៅស្ងាត់នេះខ្ញុំសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានសង្គ្រាមឆ្លោមណាធ្ងន់មិនបានទេមានចំនួនច្រើនមិនបានទេស្ងាត់ចល័តលះនេះបានធ្វើសង្គ្រាមឆ្លោមបានផ្លាស់កន្លែងឲ្យញឹកបើមិនអញ្ចឹងទេខ្មាំងវាយខ្ទេចខ្ទីអស់ហើយ
Did you ever attend any meetings at the B5 office?
ចូលរួមប្រជុំនៅមន្ទីរប5ដែរឬទេ?
ខ្ញុំដូចមិនដែលបានចូលប្រជុំនៅមន្ទីរប5ទេ គ្រាន់តែពេលទៅជួបប៉ុលពតម្ដងមួយកាលប៉ុណ្ណោះ ឯទៅប្រជុំរួមអីគេមិនដែលប្រជុំទេ
Khieu Samphan has stated in his interview with the co-investigating judges that after Phnom Penh was liberated on the 17th of April 1975, he traveled with you and Pol Pot from Pol Pot's headquarters west of Udong to Phnom Penh. How did you travel to Phnom Penh? Is it correct that you traveled withKieu Samphan
ធ្វើដំណើរដោយរបៀបណាដែរតើលោកបានធ្វើដំណើររួមជាមួយនឹងលោកខៀវសំផនដែរឬទេ
សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេព្រោះពេលនោះសភាពការវាច្បុកវាច្បល់ដែរ
So, am I correct that you don't remember whether you came to Phnom Penh from the B5 office or whether you came from Stung Chinit? Is that correct, Mr. Nguyen Chia?
Mr. Nguyen Chia, did you come from Stung Chinit? Mr.
Nguyen Chia, did you come from Stung Chinit?
Yeah, do you remember whether when you traveled to Phnom Penh after its liberation on the 17th of April 1975, did you come from the Stung Chinit River or did you come from the B5 office?
ឬក៏លោកធ្វើដំណើរពីប5មកភ្នំពេញ
តាមខ្ញុំចាំដូចជាមកពីស្ទឹងជីនិត
The last area that I want to ask you about at this time, Mr. Nguyen Chia, one of the documents that has been put before this chamber, which is case file number D108/43/1, which is before the trial chamber as E3/117, is a public statement.That was signed and issued on the 26th of February 1975 by Khieu Samphan as chairman of the Funk National Congress. That statement identified seven traitors from the Khmer Republic regime, including Lon Nol, Srikmatak, Lon Bray, and it declared it, quote, absolutely necessary to kill these seven traitors for their treason. End of quote. Now, you've told Judge Laverne on the 14th of December 2011 that you heard references to the seven Law & Noel super traitors through radio broadcasts. My question for you is whether you agree with the call for the execution of those seven leaders of the Law & Noel regime. Did you agree that those seven leaders of the Law & Noel regime were traitors and should be executed?
Your Honor, before my client answers the question, I'd like to object.
I would like the
prosecutor to be more specific. Whether my client agrees is irrelevant and also vague. My client already said it, and was not aware of the order which was given or the decision which may have been taken to maybe the prosecutor can simply ask whether my client was there when the decision was taken or whether he was informed at the time of the decision.
Well, Mr. Nunchia has indicated that he heard of this matter through radio broadcasts. As a member of the standing committee, I would like to know whether he had a view or position on whether the seven super traitors should be
executed.
Can you tell us, Mr. Nunchia, whether the standing or central committee issued any statements or instructions regarding those seven traitors from the Law & Noel regime? Am I correct then that the standing and central committee did not publicly renounce the statement calling for the execution of the seven Law & Noel traitors? Is that correct?
But you can't run all the road, but I.
I understand from your answer then that the standing and central committee did not renounce the call for the execution of the seven Law No traders. Is that correct?
ដែលមានរៀបចំទុកជាត្រាច់សម្រាប់ជនជាប់ចោតចូលរួមសម្មនាការពីចម្ងាយសម្រាប់ចុះ